Today marks 72 days since 3-year-old Orson and 4-year-old Oren West were reported missing from California City. Just this week, BPD announced they will be taking over the investigation from the Cal City Police Department. Joining us this morning, Bakersfield Police Chief Greg Terry to tell us a little bit more about this case so far. Chief, thanks so much for being with us this morning. We appreciate it.
You're very welcome. Good morning.
We know your department has been involved in this case and investigation since pretty early on. What's been the role so far and how is it changing now?
Well, we have been involved in the investigation since day one. But just based on the facts and the circumstances now known to investigators, the circumstances surrounding the disappearance of the boys and the direct nexus to Bakersfield, it just made sense where we are in the investigation after discussing with our other partners for us to take a lead role. And really what that means is we will continue the investigation, but we'll also be responsible for directly for the investigative strategies, obtaining information or resource allocation, and just really working hard, continuing to work very hard to find out what happened to these little boys.
We know that the boys used to live in Bakersfield. Does the department believe that they were missing long before it was reported in December?
We're investigating all facts and circumstances, and so investigating all possibilities as well. And we will continue to gather facts and circumstances until we know. But like I said, based on what we know now, the historical connection to Bakersfield, it just made sense for us to take the lead role, and that's what we're doing.
Can you talk a little bit more about the historical connection to Bakersfield?
Well, this is where they're from, where the family is from. And that's what I mean by that is the residence or where they were in Cal City was just for a very short period of time.
And does your department have any suspects yet in this case?
No, we're investigating all possibilities everyone is being looked at for obviously individuals, the family members, the neighbors, the sex offenders. We're exploring all possibilities and we will continue to do that until we find out what happened to these little boys.
The California City Police Department has said multiple times that the adoptive family, the family that reported the boys missing back in December from California City, has been cooperative with officers. Are they still cooperative with your officers and with this investigation?
Yeah, we've had numerous contacts with family members, immediate family members, extended family members, and everyone is still continuing to speak to us.
I know there are other children in this case with those parents. Have those children been a part of this investigation at all? Have they been spoken to or interviewed?
Like I said, we're interviewing everyone associated with it, and certainly that includes immediate family members.
We know that investigations take time and that the ultimate goal, obviously, is not keeping the public in the know necessarily, but finding the boys and solving this case. But there are still so many people holding these search parties, holding vigils. Today, there's going to be a panel discussion on the investigation so far. Do you have a message for the community about this case and everyone clamoring to know what happened to these little boys?
Well, as law enforcement officers, we are community members and we're parents also. And we understand the public's interest in this particular case, and rightfully so, to find out what happened to these little boys. But I assure you that we are going to continue the investigation in a professional and thorough manner and follow all investigative leads and possibilities. We will continue to communicate with our community, especially if there are circumstances or information that could impact our community safety or individuals in our community. We'll be very quick to share that information. But we're not going to release any information, regardless of how compelling it might be to the public interest, if it could jeopardize the outcome of this investigation. We just simply won't do it.
Are there still people out there you need to talk to? Are there still people you think who know something that could help in your investigation?
I think so. One of the things that we asked about earlier this week is we want to go back even further, not just into the immediate days or weeks surrounding the disappearance of these young boys. We asked for information for anyone who's had contact with them in the last year so that we can continue to investigate all possibilities and all facts and circumstances around what happened to these little boys.
So if anyone knows anything, is the secret witness line still the best number to call along with your police department?
If you want to remain anonymous, absolutely. If you want to have direct contact with our investigators, you can call 327-7111 and you will get connected to the investigators in the case.
All right, Chief Terry, thanks so much for joining us this morning. We appreciate it.
Thank you.